That means that it takes away my whole entire workload. I could just upload this for today.
Yeah. I'm actually going to start recording once our characters like are on the field and stuff.
Yeah.
Wait, did I send that invite?
I think you are in the party chat, right?
Alright.
Give me a second. Join.
Alright, when I start my recording, I'll just start off with like, hey everybody, I'm Konosuke 7 and stuff like that.
Alright. I got JP points for that. Oh, my sister's calling. Hello?
Coming in, huh?
Yeah.
I'm gonna talk to
her. Alright. Give me a second.
Alright.
Call it like 9 p.m. in the morning.
Oh man, it's like 9 o'clock at night.
Well, not me, night. Why am I saying morning for? But yeah, like, I'm gonna just leave the phone with her because. But yeah, we're staying like in the dorm, so. She's literally right across the hallway from me, so.
Thank God I quit. Those microtransactions were getting me.
Oh, yes.
I was like an addict, man, I swear to God.
I want to see my stuff stream. Why do I have Frieza? Well, I choose him, man. This is gonna be difficult because I never really played as Frieza much.
But right, who am I? Three,
I'm Sasuke?
Two. No, go.
Oh, I'm talking about like me, I'm Sasuke?
I'm gonna start the recording. Three, two, one.
Alright. Hey.
Alright, what's going on, everybody? I'm Konosuke 7, and today I've got a new guest with me.
Dark Zeus.
Introduce yourself.
I'm Dark Zeus.
Yeah, this is Dark Zeus. Today we're going to talk about the possibility of fusion in Dragon Ball Super. So, as everyone can pretty much tell, they've been hinting at fusion since, like, what, Battle of Gods arc?
Yep, pretty much.
Battle of Gods arc. So, what do you think? What do you think? Is it time to finally bring the fusions back? What do you think?
To be honest with you, they really should, because the simple fact is you have very difficult villains. They're very difficult villains, and they also hinted the fact in the beginning of Battle of Gods that the Vegeta and Goku should start working together instead of working distantly.
You know, I mean, is it even a spoiler at this point, now that everyone knows? But okay. Spoiler alert, in case you don't really know. The title leak for Dragon Ball Super leads people to think that Black and Zamasu were to fuse, which I don't see any other way for them to defeat them if they were to fuse. Like, Black and Zamasu were to fuse together, I could see happening with Gohatsu coming up, you know, to Goku and Vegeta going, here's take my guitar earrings and fuse, something like that, you know?
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, that's one way the scenario could come out, or, you know, because I don't, again, that's the only way I really see the fusion happening, you know?
Yeah, pretty much, because, I think that if there were to fuse, even the fusion dance, there would be a time limit, so, like, I don't think that Goku would really try to go that far, or anybody would go that far for that, you know, for that case, because that battle could very well drag along.
I would actually love to see the canonization of Gogeta and Dragon Ball Super, but realistically speaking, the fusion that we might see if we were to see fusions would probably be Vegito.
Yeah. Also, I remember when Goku had asked, Kabuto Kai and Supreme Kai, how was they able to defuse? And they explained that they used the Dragon Balls to defuse themselves, so they could use this actual method in Dragon Ball Super if they were to fuse as Vegeta.
Now, that's another thing people have been wondering, but it makes sense why they've been wondering, because, again, like I said, it explains how they could defuse Vegito. How would they defuse? I mean, they've already explained they can wish to be a part with the Dragon Ball, so, I mean, it's not impossible.
That's true.
I mean, yeah, with the whole Super Buu thing, yeah, they did get lucky with that. But, again, you can go to Namek, you can go to Earth, there's Super Dragon Balls. I mean, you have a bunch of possibilities to unfuse. So fusion could very possibly happen.
Yep, it's very possible, actually. And to all honesty, I think that the fusion used currently, if it was Batara earrings, it could really work in their favor, because also symbolically, because they're both Batara fused warriors, that battle could drag on very long, and they'll be very powerful. They don't have to be balanced or anything. They both could be at their peak of their Super Saiyan Blue form and fuse together to make the Ultimate Warrior.
Now, we've been talking about Goku and Vegeta fusing, but what we've actually been ignoring here was how powerful Black and Zamasu will be as their own fusion together. Black Zamasu, Black Blasu, whatever anyone wants to call them. How powerful would they be? We've seen how strong they are, their teamwork, when they synchronize their attacks and stuff like that. So, them as a fused being, how do you think that'll work out, Zeus?
Honestly, I think it'll work out pretty good, because the fact is, you have on one side Zamasu being immortal that could transfer over to his fusion, and also Black being able to give himself a forced Zenkai boost. It clearly shown after Goku had fought well, basically himself, which technically is Zamasu, after he went back in time, after he went forward in time, he had gave himself the ability to learn Goku's moves. So this could very well be a very difficult battle for Vegito if Vegito was there, because he was able to see his moves, counter it, and also that with a bonus of immortality.
Bonus immortality, and that's not even mentioning the whole Super Saiyan Rose transformation as well. Now, we don't know if Super Saiyan Rose transformation will completely go over to Black Zamasu and Black Zamasu, because Super Saiyan Rose is a transformation that Black can use, because technically he is Zamasu in Goku's body, he's in a Saiyan's body. And if Saiyan's body mixed with a Kai's body, are they still able to turn Super Saiyan Rose? I think maybe, because that would make him half Saiyan, half Kai, and Goten and Trunks can turn Super Saiyan while they're half Saiyan. So Black Zamasu turning Super Saiyan Rose while fused, it's definitely a possibility, and it's a very real possibility.
Pretty much.
And, He's definitely someone to fear. Black is definitely the strongest opponent in DBZ. So, fusion is really the only way I see them beating these guys, especially with their very good teamwork. No one can deny that.
Yes, like, especially since they're the same person, and effectively they could use their, you know, their same fighting style together and complement each other. So that really plays into their effect as well. So, like, I really wanted to see actual, like, Trunks turning into another form. Everybody wanted to see that. And to not have that included, it's just weird. Like, I honestly seen, like, I want to see, like, okay, if they were going to fuse, I want to see, like, Trunks fuse somebody. Because we're already seeing Vegeta fuse with somebody. You know, Goku fuse with Vegeta. And we've already seen Gotenks. I want to see a Vegetunks, you know?
I agree. And something that's been in my head for a little while, a little bit off topic of the whole fusion thing. Do you think that there's another level beyond Super Saiyan Rose? Super Saiyan Rose is without doubt Super Saiyan, but with a rose color. Could there be a Super Saiyan Rose 2, Super Saiyan Rose 3, with Super Saiyan Rose color? I think the only thing Akira got right is the symbolic part.
Like, imagine if were Zamasu and, you know, Black were to fuse. They both have rose colored hair. You have the white rose and you have the pink or red rose, you know? So that could really work. Like, imagine they fuse. They turn into a whole new different form entirely and become a new Super Saiyan Rose.
I very much agree. I think that could happen. Would that ending satisfy you?
Honestly, it really wouldn't satisfy me, for the simple fact is, the Mafuba, like, when you go and look back at Dragon Ball, the Mafuba takes away the user's life force. And for them to use it, they have to bring that out. They have to bring that out and say, hey, we messed up. We actually remember that this move kills you. So for them to use that move again and not have it kill Goku when he used that move is outrageous.
Yes, it would be outrageous.
And imagine they bring that up. Imagine they bring that up, and next thing you know, just Vegito just falls out. Like, ugh. You're like, what happened?
Black is actually the most intriguing villain I've seen in Dragon Ball come out in a while. I mean, his amount of evilness is definitely equal to rival Frieza, in my opinion.
Well, yeah, but I think that the difference between Frieza and Black, Frieza covered up a lot of stuff. They were like politics. Imagine, I would say, I don't want to bring politics into it, but I imagine Black is Donald Trump. He's upright. He'll say it. He might be wrong in his situation, but he'll hold up to his opinions. He'll hold up to his word, and he'll hold up to everything he just said. And he will literally lie in your face, or he will literally say the truth in your face, and he means 100% by it. And Frieza is the kind of person that will cover it up. He'll say, oh, an asteroid hit it. Don't worry about it, you know? Even though he's the one that pretty much destroyed planet Vegeta. So everybody got their own ways of being evil, but I would say that, in all honesty, mine's leaning toward more towards Black because he's more sadistic. And when it comes down to Frieza, I'm a little bit more on his side when it comes down to being an organized dictator, an organized lord. He literally just commanded an entire race and fooled them, all of them, and let no secrets come out. And he killed the king. He killed the king and nobody knew. That takes the amount of manipulation that takes is outstanding.
It is true. A lot of things could have happened in Dragon Ball Super with this arc looking like it's coming to an end. And it could play out in some very good ways, and it could also play out in some very bad ways as well.
Yes.
Hopefully, maybe you're teamed up. Hopefully, it'll play out good. And they won't ruin this arc like Resurrect Frieza, Goku stole Vegeta's kill, something like that. Pretty much. I personally think Goku should not be the one to defeat Black, or Vegeta, or Trunks, but if they were to defeat Black Maximus, I would accept that. But I still think that Trunks deserves the final kill, but
I would prefer it be a fusion and just Goku by himself, you know.
But yeah, they should really do something with Trunks. Like, they bring him out and they make him hurt so much and they not do nothing with him and just make him look like the guy who holds everything. He's basically, I wouldn't say the Yamcha, but I would say the Yamcha. I have to do it. He's the Yamcha of the series at this point. He holds them off for them to get, you know, more cover, like, so he's more or less the port, and he should not be because it's affecting his future. It's not affecting Goku's in the slightest.
I actually hope so, man. I hope, but it looks like I've actually went back. And looked at Goku versus introducing the fusion, and it was referenced something about a five-man fusion, and I was like, five-man fusion? One in Dragon Ball fusions? I thought that was just a made-up thing they made just made up for the game. I was like, what's an actual thing? So what I saw on YouTube was someone saying the possibility of a three-man fusion of Vegeta, Trunks, and Goku all fusing together all at once. Wow, whoa, that's... But what do you think? I think that's a forward right there.
Oh, yes. Like, but it would be amazing to see such a new thing added. And then, during, after this arc, or as soon as that arc comes around, the Universe Tournament arc, it'd be nice to see that fusion take place.
And the Universe Tournament, it would actually be nice to see Trunks make a return. We know after this arc, he is most likely going to stay in his future. We don't want that, we want him to stay, but realistically, he's probably going to stay in his future.
Yeah, and also because it's a crime.
Yeah.
He'll be a vigilante in the tournament. Like, they'll probably try to arrest him on the spot. Especially if Zeno's there. You'll probably know what's up.
Back to the subject of fusion, I do think fusion is definitely a possibility and definitely a good addition to Dragon Ball Super. It would make Dragon Ball Super ten times better to show us a Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta or Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta. Because I'm pretty sure there are plenty of people who This isn't a good idea to watch Dragon Ball Super without watching Dragon Ball Z, but I'm pretty sure some people watch Dragon Ball Super and have never watched Dragon Ball Z, and don't know who Vegeta or Gogeta even is, and they were introduced to them that way, it would be a great time.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Alright, well, this has been this discussion video for the possibility of Fusion and Dragon Ball Super. Thank you guys for watching. And make sure you hit up Dark Zeus on YouTube and check him out and subscribe.
Thank you so much, man.
So thank you guys for watching. See you next time.
Alright.
Alright, and that's my video saved.
Alright. How do I save mine?
I did the whole double tap the share button and it records, and then you save the video thing.
Oh, so like I could just end the stream right then and there, it'll auto save, or
you were live streaming?
Yeah, I was live streaming through YouTube too.
Okay, if you were live streaming and you stopped your live stream, it'll save whatever we did, and it'll auto upload it to YouTube. What I did was to record off of the PS4, you just double hit the share button and hit, there's a little record button that'll come up in the corner. And then when I'm done, I hit the share button again and then save video clip, and it'll save the clip, and then you go to the share factory, and that's where you can edit it through there and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I do. And whenever I want to do a live stream, that's when I'm just like, yeah, I'll do a live stream.
To like
so let me check out this recording and see if our voices were picked up without any issue. I didn't really hear your voice that loud. Is your voice set to allow to be shared?
Yeah.
Why wasn't it good to hear you? How's your microphone level?
It's up high. Like I put it up real, real high. Double check. Oh man, this stream doing me some good, cause like I literally just went up like 10 cents in my analytics.
Let me see here. Yeah, I can't really hear your voice in my end on the recording.
But at least I'll hear mine on the other side, wouldn't I?
Yeah. You wanna double check on your party settings and check your voice?
Sure.
How to prioritize party.
What is it? Oh my goodness gracious.
It wasn't loud.
Oh. Oh my goodness. So this is a one-side conversation?
Just put it to always allowed. That's what I do.
Like, I usually, like, think of that, like, you know. When they put it, like, should I put, like, the max audio mix? Or just leave it as is?
Audio mix. Mine's party audio all the way up.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
And the microphone level, mine is all the way up as well.
Alright, there's up.
Well, we can't use that gameplay. What do you think? You want to try again on the whole recording?
You could actually, I could give you, like, my side, and, like, no, that wouldn't work either, because, like, then you have to sync the audio together, and they're both combined into the gameplay.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It wouldn't bother me if we were to restart the recording and try again.
Sure. Well, first I gotta find out how to archive my stream. Because once I archive it, not to worry about, like, you know, uploading it, because it's already uploaded under my YouTube.
What do you mean archive it, like, from YouTube?
Yeah.
What do you mean archive? Like, so you can upload it?
Like, it'll already be, like, saved under the YouTube. Like, you know how, like, some people be streaming and have, like, a stream archive or something like that?
I'm not too sure what you mean.
Like, you could look up, like, PewDiePie. And then PewDiePie would have, like, a stream archive, but it might not be his, but there are people who archive his streams or something like that.
Okay. I see what you mean.
But, like, I probably have to make, like, a video like you did.
All right, so for this redo, you want to do J-Stars again, or you want to try a different game?
J-Stars, because I already have it in.
I'll say, if we're talking about anime games, I can name out the anime games I got, if you have as well.
Only thing I have, like, anime-wise, I have to literally go back and, like, I have to literally go out and get my PS3, then set up the remote play, and they'll take a while because they have to both, you know, connect together, and then have to set up the exploit and stuff like that.
But for the PS4, I got Xenoverse, Naruto 4, Attack on Titan, and that's it.
I have, like, Street Fighter, I have, like, One Piece, and I have, like, J-Stars. That's about it, because this is actually a new PS4, I mean.
Alright, so, hop back on J-Stars.
See if I can, like, archive it. I might not even worry about archiving it, for the simple fact is, people are just going to view the stream as is. And... How are people seeing the stream when I can't see my own stream? Come on now. How are people seeing the stream I can't see? I want to see my stream. Broadcast alert. What that is. Edit insertion, create highlight. Oh, yeah. Sync to preview. This is making it too difficult. Just put, like, something. Thumbnail. Put a thumbnail. That's something to think about. I'm gonna put a thumbnail there for funsies. Just for people to, like, see, not like a... The thing is, the base thumbnail for this is, like, you know how when you stream, you see, like, the PlayStation camera and, like, the little PlayStation little blocks loading? That's my thumbnail.
Oh, yeah.
Join. Put, like, a J-Stars picture in it. Because I have, like, one saved on my computer. Put, like, a random one.
Alright, let's pick a character. Wow, I'm gonna have to talk all over again.
We can just keep it to a minimum and condense it. Because, yeah, you know.
But we still gotta go in depth a little bit to keep people interested. and go, oh yeah, that's true. When they're listening, you know?
Yeah, we could do that too. It's just like we can like list it off as points. Like, okay, we get down to Gogeta, we list off points for Gogeta, and then for Vegito, we list off points for Vegito, and then we come up with a base synopsis, like they do with You ever seen the battle thing that Screw Attack be doing? They list off the first person character, and they list off their powers, and then the second one, and they list out their powers, and they give up a battle off in the end, and based upon the different individuals who's fighting, that person comes out the victor.
Alright, well, let me know when you're ready with your character selection.
Alright. Wonder, should I choose Kokoro? I really want to try Gon, because, like, I love his character. I don't know why, but, like, I love Hunter x Hunter. I don't know why I don't really show it that much, though, but I'm going to put some Hunter. I'm going to draw some Hunter x Hunter. Best believe I'm drawing me some Hunter x Hunter. I picked, like, two Gons.
Right. Wow.
No, I didn't. God dang it, Eric. Why? I forgot to save my characters. I keep doing that. Even when I like do my recordings, like for YouTube, I play that J-Star.
Instead of pressing start.
Yes. And it irks me so much. Damn it. Are there two select buttons? Damn you, Sony. Alright.
Alright, we're all ready. Alright, we're gonna record 3, 2, 1. Alright, what's going on, everybody? I'm Konosuke 7, and today I have a brand new guest with me.
Dark Seuss.
This is a good friend, Dark Seuss, here. Today we're gonna talk about the possibility of fusion in Dragon Ball Super. So, if any of you have been keeping up with Dragon Ball Super, obviously you would know that in a future episode, Leak, Black and Zamasu are in fact going to do fusion. So, Seuss, what do you think about them two doing fusion? What do you think?
I think it's pretty good because it really gives a lot of new ways of Goku and Vegeta handling a situation, because not only did they go back into the future to fight Black again and again, but to give him an even more difficult opponent to fight, they really have to buckle down and work together on it.
They actually do have to work together a lot more than they've been doing. Because of the whole Black and Zamasu's teamwork that they've been portraying very well, especially with their very good synchronization. With their attack synchronizing and perfectly being in line, Goku and Vegeta don't really fight like that. They've never really fought an opponent that fought like that either. And with them going to fuse in a few episodes from now, that is definitely one pain in the ass they have to deal with. And I don't see any other way from them beating them than fusing.
Pretty much.
That's the only way I can see Goku and Vegeta beating Black and Zamasu, unless they were to pull something out of their ass and do some magical crazy shit.
The only thing I think, to be honest with you, they'll pull out is either the Mafuba, because they've been practicing it, or Trunks being like getting like a Zenkai boost, or Trunks end up getting a 2 transformation.
Hopefully Trunks does get a Zenkai boost and get the Super Saiyan Blue form himself, because as you can see, he has some God Ki forming around him when this new false Super Saiyan God transformation or whatever this is, we can see there is God Ki around him. So there is definitely potential he's showing. But I honestly don't think that'll be enough for a fusion of Black and Zamasu, which we can call Black Zamasu. So, three Super Saiyan Blues is most likely not going to be enough to take down Black Zamasu. And Again, it would be great to see the return of Vegito or the canonization of Gogeta. Because either of those fusions turned into a Super Saiyan Blue, I wholeheartedly believe is strong enough to take down Black Zamasu. Not easily, but I think they would be able to take him out.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, to be honest with you, if they do bring out both, if they either bring out Vegeta or Gogeta, that really shows how serious that situation is for them to bring up Fusion. Because the last time Fusion was used is when Boo became so extremely powerful that he was ripping through time and space. Remember when he got that angry to that point?
When he was stuck in a hyperbolic time chamber?
Yeah, even that. Like, remember when Vegeta had fought Buhan, and when Buhan got pissed off that Vegeta was playing with him, to the point where he was like ripping holes in time and space. And even when he fought Gotenks, his anger became that to that point where he ripped the holes through the hyperbolic time chamber. So like, to use fusion is a serious moment, and then like to define that moment, fighting Black as a Gogeta or Vegeta Super Saiyan Blue shows how serious and seriously strong Black and Zamasu is.
You know, Fusion is shown to be the final trump card throughout the entire Dragon Ball series, and it shows how serious the situation has gotten whenever a character is shown to use it. Unless you're Goten and Trunks who do it all the damn time for like no reason. But you know, whatever. And you know, Black and Zamasu are very, very, very powerful characters together. And again, like I said, I don't see them beating them unless they work to fuse. Now, I would be a little satisfied if Goku and Vegeta start fighting while synchronizing like Black and Zamasu were. But again, for the absolute kill itself, It would most likely have to be fusion. And the difference between the two is, well, like you said, Vegeta was playing with Buhan when he was fighting him. So, if it's very possible that if Vegeta were to come up and start fighting Black Zamasu, he would probably start toying with Black Zamasu just like he did Buhan. And Gogeta, hopefully, as a Super Saiyan Blue, would not act like Gogeta as a Super Saiyan 4 and start playing with the opponent. And just wasting his huge time and not taking the fight seriously. And hopefully he would have to sit there and be like, this is serious. I need to go in for the kill or else this guy's going to take out the entire future and kill all of humanity, you know?
Yeah. The funny thing is,
this is a very dire situation and most likely the most serious situation that the Z-Warriors have been put through. And they can, I do believe they can defeat them. Now, defeating Zamasu, that's not going to be very easy. You're definitely going to have to use your head on that one. But defeating Black, since he is not immortal, he can be defeated. And if they were to fuse, would Zamasu's immortality roll over to the fused Black Zamasu? I think, yeah. I think, yes. And it would definitely spell very, very, very bad trouble.
Yeah. Like, one thing I really had an issue with, when it came to, Black and Zamasu, they never really wanted to, like, go into Goku's actual present and go after him. They just sat there in Trunks' timeline, and they wanted to wipe out humanity in Trunks' timeline, which actually had little to no humanity as a, you know, as a whole.
I was actually watching over the episode before I did the recording for this, and I actually went over, I actually forgot about this scene, I don't know how, about Black telling Goku about how he killed his wife, and I was like, oh man, now I still don't feel that bad at Goku or the kill, which I hope I'm not jinxing it because I do retract that, and I am hoping that Vegeta or Trunks get the final kill, but Black sure has hit Goku, Vegeta, and Trunks personally on a personal level because Trunks destroyed his world. Vegeta killed Vegeta's wife and terrorized Trunks' life
and his home. And for Goku, stole his body, killed his wife, and his son. So Black definitely has made some dangerous enemies.
Oh, yes. But he has the power to back it up, though.
That is true.
When a lot of Goku's enemies came around, they had the power to back it up, but they knew that Goku could get stronger and stronger. And that was their ultimate downfall, was toying with Goku, or Goku toying with them. But the thing is, with Black, he doesn't have to toy around. He knows his strength, and he knows Goku's strength, and he knows that he's able to make up for that by learning.
Black Zamasu is a fighting technique since they are the same person. Their fighting technique is outstanding, as you can see. They do a particular pose whenever they're about to do certain moves and stuff like that. They fight very elegant and fight with grace, you know. And when it carries over into the Black Zamasu, That is something that is very dangerous because it's Dragon Ball. We don't see a lot of characters fight with much technique, you know. Really, what we see a lot is really just punch really hard, bust through buildings, stuff like that. Very rarely do we see a character fight with technique and fighting style, you know. Last time we saw something like that was around Dragon Ball. Actually, you saw it in Dragon Ball Z and you didn't even notice it.
Let me tell you where it was. Future 18 and Future 17.
Oh, yeah, you're right, actually.
They fought with grace, and they fought basically in synchronized. Like, they were terrorists, and
Their synchronization was very good, but I do not think it was better than Black and Zamasu's. Theirs is like a whole other level.
But the thing is, they're the same person, so they know their same fighting style. But 18 and 17 are different people. They do not. They can't read each other's mind, or they can't know each other's style that, you know, that perfectly. But they just work together.
I am very much hoping that Goku and Vegeta go out, comes up to Goku and Vegeta and goes, here, take my Pitar fusion or something like that. And I've actually been thinking, since Vegeta is a fusion of Goku and Vegeta, does that technically make Vegeta a Kai?
Well,
what do you think, since wearing the Pitar earrings does in fact promote you to the status of Kai, which he did explain to Zamasu in an earlier episode. So when Vegeta puts on those earrings, does that mean he's a Kai?
Well, to be frank with you, I think that Kai is more of a race thing. Like, it's like saying, oh, if I could rap, I could be this. Or if I could do this, I could be that. I think it's more of a race thing, but you could be a pseudo Kai. You could be like a fake Kai. You could still have the qualifications and the rank of a Kai, but also be a human being or a Saiyan or whatever. But I think that it's more of a race.
That does actually make a lot more sense.
Because, like, we don't see a lot of different variations of Kai being other races, but they're, you know, they're similar style. You know, they could be pink and blue and yellow, but they all look the same when it comes down to actual race.
I think there's a little bit more to the fusion between the Pitar earrings. I feel like there's more to that that we just don't know about. I can't really explain what, but I just feel like there's more to it that we just don't know.
Because, like, you know what I think? If there were to fuse, it would be funny if Gowasu gave Vegito the time ring and went back in time and fixed a lot of the stuff. Like, killed... the Zamasu that killed Chi-Chi and killed the Zamasu that killed Bulma and fixed Trunks' timeline.
That's a very interesting thing, you know? That could play out very interestingly.
Because to bring out the fact that they can use the Batar earrings to, the earrings in general to control the time ring, that will really play into the favor of the actual series, like, to implement that to a good character, not just a bad character.
That is true. Yeah. I love Dragon Ball, always have, and we all know how picky our Dragon Ball community is gonna be about the ending of certain stuff. And I do believe that if this arc does not end in a very specific way, people will, to put it bluntly, bitch.
Yeah, pretty much.
Black and Zamasu, again, their synchronization is great. It's on top. I've never seen anything that was that powerful with their synchronization. And their fusion would definitely be a very powerful one. Now, I've seen tons of fan art of used Black Zamasu with green skin and white hair, and same color skin as Zamasu, standing up white hair again. Most of them that I see is with their hair being style of Super Saiyan Rose, but the color of Zamasu's. How do you think the fused Black Zamasu will look?
I think the way they will look is more like how Gotenks looking in his base form.
But with the hair colors mixed, like a little bit of both?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually more realistic of what would happen. I feel like his overall appearance would lean more towards Black's facial expression, his complexion, and stuff like that, and his facial features, and basically I think he would look like even more menacing Goku with little subtle Zamasu appearances here and there.
That's true. Like, especially with the whole outline of Zamasu's eyes that you can barely see, I think it'll have those and stuff. They'll look really cool, to be honest with you. I might even draw that.
That's a good idea.
Draw it before it comes out, and be like, oh, he took his idea.
Yeah, patent pending.
Yep. Black Tatsu is now ours.
That's a very interesting thing, though, because think about it, we haven't really seen much Dragon Ball characters really fused. I mean, Dragon Ball villains. We don't really see much of them fused, you know? I mean, we've seen Blue fuse and Cell really absorption, which I guess you can say is a form of fusing in a way. But I wouldn't count it as a fusion that we're really aiming more towards or talking about, you know? Am I even making any sense? Cell was definitely a unique character, but I think he was more of an absorption thing.
Yeah, that's true. Because, like, I remember back when, before they knew about Black's, like, being Zamasu, I remember back then they thought that, oh, they took Goku's body and, you know, back from the dead, or, you know, they probably went back in time and made Goku evil or something like that.
I've heard theories saying Black was Goten.
What? Why would they say that?
I was like, Goten? Are you serious?
Why would it even be Goten? That's the thing, because, like, Goten wasn't even alive.
I'm guessing that they thought Zamasu would kidnap Goten as a child and raise him as his own. I could see that happening if Goten was an infant. The dude is, like, 10 years old, as if he can, like, I'm pretty sure he knows what not to do and not to listen to until now.
Unless
Zamasu were
to
threaten his life, then
maybe
I could see Goten, you know.
The thing is, would Goku be in this situation, though? The thing is, even if Zamasu were to kidnap Goten, what would Goku be in this situation? I think that Goku would probably chase him down, you know?
Yeah. Just like he did with Raditz kidnapping Gohan.
Raditz kidnapping Trunks. To be honest with you...
So the whole fusion and Dragon Ball Super, I'm actually pretty excited for it.
Yeah, me too. Like, the fusion should be work... The fusion should really work well into the cooperation of both characters. That should have been shown in the Resurrection of F arc.
As long as they play things out correctly, don't ruin the characters, and don't make them play around too much in the fight, and take the fight seriously, it could be more epic than Super Saiyan Blue Kyle times 10.
Yeah.
It could be more epic than that moment if they were played right and played out correctly.
Yep. That would be awesome.
Alright, well, thank you guys for watching. This has been our discussion video on the possibilities of fusion and Dragon Ball Super. Make sure you look up Dark Zeus on YouTube, or go over and subscribe to his channel and check out his videos.
Thank you, man.
So thank you guys for watching, and see you next time.
Alright, later.
Alright, video clip is safe. Now let's check if it plays and audio is correct.
Hopefully.
Yep, we can hear you.
Awesome. Well, now I can end my stream now. Goodbye, guys. I like to keep it unprofessional. I like the unprofessionalism.